So hello guys, now we are going to see what is the use of dir function. So this is a built-in function and it just returns the names defined in the particular module. And if we have no names defined, then it will return the particular, built-ins and all. So let us try to run it now. So this is the syntax, dir simply. And if you run this, nothing will happen because obviously I didn't do anything. I'll have to print it out. So I'll print out dir so that we understand what is happening. So when I print this out, it will return these all things. I don't know, obviously I don't know what all this, but these are the names defined in this particular module. But if you define some module before this, so this is when we didn't define any names or anything. So first of all, let us create some variables and all to make it more interesting. So suppose A is random variable and L is random list, and these are any random things, right? Okay, fine. And afterwards, if you print dir, so okay, something is wrong here. Whatever. Okay, so see now what did it do is it saw A and L as well, so it added. So basically, when we write print, okay, hold on. What I'll do, I'll just copy this thing and paste it first, so that we get what is happening when we run it first and afterwards as well. So when we print dir, at this time no name or no list is defined. So A and L are not defined. So if you see over here, A and L are not included in the first statement of or the first printout. So after we define A and L and then we print out the directory or dir, then it will simply print out these all things, but it will append A and L as well because we included A and L, and that is we defined them. So this is one of the uses, and one more way is to you can get the specific directories. Hold on, I'll just print out dir of any particular module. So what is happening over here? Suppose you want the directory of math module. You might know the math module. So obviously it is not defined, so I'll have to import it first. So import math, and if you print out the dir of math, it will simply print out the whole directory of math. So it has these functions as well. So first of all, these predefined names and all that, I don't know what they are, but afterwards these functions and all are defined and we can use them, seal and all, cos, square root and all. You can use these functions at always. So you can basically print out the directory. So suppose you import, hold on. Wow, I'm not able to type this. So suppose you import say sys now, and you print, try to print out. Sys is also one more module. Sys, you don't print out sys. Now you try to print out dir of sys and run this code. So see, this is the whole directory of sys now. So this is basically the use of dir function. That's all. Thank you.